I'm here this morning with Rob DeMacy, and Rob's a young shipwright that's working on this lobster yacht here. And
This is a 40-foot Malcolm Brewer lobster style hull, and we're doing some minor repair work to some rotted wood areas.
I love them.
It's a cool layout.
The layout and stuff is just fantastic. You know? What a nice boat to picnic on. This thing must be.
What type of wood is it?
Well, let's take a look at it, and I'm going to take a little scraping of it here, not to alter the shape at all, but just so I can look at the wood a little bit easier. And I would say that this covering board right here is Douglas fir. And the reason why I say that is because by the appearance of the grain here, your annual rings are, it's this quarter sawn, and the annual rings are coming right up at you. But the width of these harder rings and then the soft rings, this is fir. This is a very soft grain line here. This is very hard. And the widths tell me that this is fir. Then I get into the decking itself, and I'm going to do a little scraping of that. But you see the nature of this is so much different between this wood and this wood. This has got your hard and soft grain line. This wood is fairly consistent all the way across. You can see the hard grain line, but it's very, very narrow, and the softer line is wider, and the softer is not even as soft as the soft grain lines in the fir. This is much easier to compress in the softer grain line than this is. This is some sort of spruce, and this is Douglas fir. Yeah, that is the kind of situation I'm talking about. It's very possible that right here, the canvas might actually just hover right over there and may not quite be touching. But there is gravity. Gravity will help hold it down in an area like that. There used to be sold what they called a canvas cement that they used to paint on and then bed the canvas in a cement. You know, and it's been done that way over the years. But the problems with it is that if the boat does any flexing, like say a sailboat, say a sail like a Herreshoff, if the deck were to flex and that canvas is glued down, it immediately rips the canvas. So, you know, any boat that's got a flexibility to it, over the years, a lot of shipwrights have decided, well, I'm not going to glue the canvas down. I'm not going to stick it down. I'm going to let it float, right? That way, if the boat changes shape, you might even get a wrinkle across the canvas on the deck of, say, a Herreshoff 15 or something like that, but it doesn't wreck the canvas because it isn't glued down. The boat's allowed to work a little bit, and the canvas is actually just sitting on the surface. And that's probably the best situation. They might stretch it over the outside edge and then tack that edge. But in order to get it tight, they would actually put water on it after it's tacked down. Well, as the water soaks into the canvas, actually spread water on it. And then what happens is the canvas, it starts to swell up. It gets tighter, you know, because the water's on it. Then you let the surface of it kind of dry, and the canvas is still wet.
Underneath.
And you paint it with oil-based paint while the canvas is still wet. Okay. And that is one method.
Okay.
So I would let the canvas float on it. And as from what I've seen so far, you're on the right road here.
Good.
Exactly the right road. You're not looking for it to be bone dry. So what you're looking for is to have the moisture contact come back in the deck again after the boat is launched. In which case, it will swell some, and some of this stuff will close up. You can obviously tell by looking at this that this was tight before.
Mm-hmm.
Well, it's going to get tight again, and that's why I say don't fill it, because it allows it to swell. I think that once the canvas is put on there, that you're going to find out that that's going to swell back up again. Of course, you won't know it's going to be under the canvas.
Right.
But you would know it if you puttied it solid and it swelled up, because it would rip the canvas. That would make it so that the planking won't swell and push, you know, the decking off the cowl. And just to take a quick look at this, this is something I wouldn't do. You see what they've done here? They've hollowed out the bottom of the tow rail. And I suspect that the reason why they've done that is they wanted to set it on the deck and have it show very little or no space whatsoever on the two edges. So they're concerned about whether or not it's sitting down on a flat surface. So they hollow the center out, and then when they make contact with the deck and fasten it down, it's going to be very tight on the two edges. But I'm not in favor of doing that, because in the first place, you've got to use an awful lot of some sort of bedding to fill this thing all back up again. If you hadn't made that groove in the first place, then we wouldn't have to fill it back up again.
Huh?
So there'd be no sense in doing that. If anything, you might make it a tiniest little bit hollow across, but you're talking a 64th of an inch in between here,
okay,
you know, in the center, if at all.
Yeah.
More or less, maybe even just with sandpaper. And the edges will still sit down. But when you put it on the deck, you have your opportunity to take a quick look at it and press it down tight and see whether or not the edges are sitting down the way you want it. And if there's some point where it's not, well, then you could go to something like this, but it certainly wouldn't be cut in as deep as this and require this much filler. This is being the original. This is a replacement piece. This is the original here. This is a replacement piece. So this whole deck up forward here has been removed at one time, and something's been done in here. You know, whether or not it's a breast hook, or they decided to cut the stem head off because it was rotten, or you know, we don't know. So this is going to be a new bowsprit here.
Yeah. And
do you have another? Do you have another term for that other than a bowsprit? It's not a bowsprit. It's a pulpit.
Is it a pulpit?
You're sure, okay. It's a pulpit.
I didn't know if the pulpit was the bars on the top. I feel like an idiot here because I should know.
We call that
well
the pulpit
enough.
Railing, no?
Okay.
And this would be the pulpit, I believe. Well, that's what takes care of a situation like this, because you got different colors and different qualities of wood and different things. And in order to get that to look somewhat a match, it has to be stained up to a darker color. Otherwise, if you put, you know, you put varnish on this, you're going to obviously have two different colors of wood. So that's one of the reasons why people ever started staining, was to get all the, even in the same tree, you have different colors of wood and different grain mat, different grain, and when you stain it, it all looks pretty much the same. It's a consistency thing, because that way it doesn't draw your eyes to this piece or to that piece. The best case scenario in a situation like this is like when they built it. The canvas went under the windshield frame. It was put down first. The windshield was put over.
It goes way back.
Now, it doesn't provide for repairing it, and they obviously knew back then that canvas wasn't going to last forever. But they treated it as well as they could. They tried to make it last forever. It didn't, but they certainly tried. So what they did when they built it was they ran the canvas down, and then they put the cleat that this piece of wood is up against on first over the canvas, then this is fastened to that. It's possible that there are no fastenings coming up from the decking into this frame right here. And if that is the case, you could actually take one of those vibrating tools, a multi-tool, I think they call it
fine
now,
multi-mass,
and lay it down on the deck and probably cut out from underneath this just enough space possibly to put the canvas in. Because that's the prettiest situation, is to just have the canvas end and the windshield pick up. You know, when you put a piece of wood around there, like a piece of molding over that, you've got other problems. One is trying to keep that piece on. One is the maintenance of that piece. The other is the appearance of it. You know, whether it's maintained properly and it's perfectly tight or otherwise. Do you like the look of it? Most people wouldn't. You know, so it might be a nice idea to push the canvas underneath this windshield frame, in which case you'll have to make, obviously, a slot in there.
Lou, thanks for coming down.
Yeah,
really.
Yeah, no, it was a pleasure.
Awesome to see you again, and thanks for all the help.
Well, thank you. Yeah. Thanks for having me, and I'm hoping to come back and get a good look at it again after some more work's been accomplished.
Good. You're welcome to come back. I hope you do.
I will.